you are God. Have mercy now on your servant, whose long life is spent in your service. Give him a place in your kingdom, where hope is firm for all who love, and rest is sure for all who serve. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Songs. Out of the depths I call to you. Lord, hear my cry. May your ears be attentive to my cry for mercy. If you, Lord, mark our sins, Lord, who can stand? But with you is forgiveness, and so you are revered. I wait for longing for the Lord. My soul waits for his word. My soul looks for the Lord more than sentinels for daybreak. More than sentinels for daybreak, let Israel look for the Lord. For with the Lord is kindness. With him is for redemption. And God will redeem Israel from all their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I give you a new commandment, love one another. As I have loved you, so also should you love one another. This is how all will know that you are my disciples. And if you love one another, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I'm going to prepare a place for you, then I will come back again and take you myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will also know the Father. From now on, you know him and have seen him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The hour had come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life will lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and will glorify it again. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Reading a little biography, I guess you can call it, about Basil. Why one thing stood out in my mind, and that was his love for gardening. Maybe because I've just finished planting my own. Maybe because it's spring, a time to plant, a time of waiting for the crops to be ready at the end of the year. I thought, how many seeds did Basil plant in his life? Not just the seeds that will grow into plants, but other seeds that would lead to eternal life. I know there will be eulogies later on, and I don't want to take away from them. But I do want to highlight a few seeds that I think Basil sowed throughout his life. One was his love for family gatherings with friends and family. Sowing the seeds of family life is a great and essential gift. Another seed that Basil sowed was helping others, helping especially those who are seeking a new life, a better life in Canada. And another seed was travel, not just going to different places, but going to new places, experiencing new cultures, in ways that expand our appreciation for God's creation. Strictly speaking, the obvious interpretation of the gospel is the grain of wheat, referring to the end of life, leading to eternal life. But I think we can add to that, that throughout our lives, we have opportunity to sow seeds of good works, in the hopes that these good works will bear fruit in the lives of others, not just our desire for eternal life. Looking back at Basil's life, how did the good works of his life bear fruit in other people's lives? How many lives did he touch? Which were the gifts that bore fruit in your own lives? Due to the restrictions of COVID, many things have been changed, and one is how we celebrate the funerals, the rituals around mourning. And it was not uncommon for a delay between the time somebody passes away and their funeral, sometimes up to 2 years. One advantage is that it's easier to focus on the funeral of what we are celebrating, because the sense of loss, hopefully, is somewhat eased. We can reflect in a deeper way on what we're celebrating. We're coming to the end of the church's Easter season, when we celebrated the death and resurrection of Jesus. And it's interesting to look at his disciples. At first, they're caught up in their loss. Then they struggled to understand, how could the person they loved die and come back to life? They saw the risen Lord, but did not understand what it meant. But in time, as they returned to their day-to-day lives, they were changed by their encounter with the risen Christ. The gospel gives us key events surrounding his resurrection, but not a clear time frame for the disciples to take to heart what had happened. And it's certain that it was not as orderly and as quick as we see in the Gospels. Our experience of mourning is similar to that of the disciples. We have an advantage of their experience of loving somebody who died and seeing them rise again. When a loved one dies, we have that initial grief, we're caught up in loss. And at some point, our hearts begin to contemplate the resurrection, that our loved one has gone to a better place. And eventually, we find peace in that, but there's no straight line. There is no time frame that fits all people. But as long as we move forward, we are moving forward with faith. Remembering is not simply recalling, calling to mind something, As church, we remember Jesus best, not by remembering what he did, but by doing what he did, by loving God and others. We keep him alive by the good works that Jesus did. In the same way, it is true with Basil. There are many ways to remember, not simply saying Basil did this or that, but by remembering and doing what he did, sowing the seeds of goodness in the lives of others, and doing that in remembrance of Basil, keeping him alive through what we do. Jesus is risen, firstborn of the dead. With confidence in salvation he brings, we now confidently offer prayers. Our response is, hear us, O Lord.
Christ is risen, the firstborn of the dead. With confidence in the salvation he brings, we now confidently offer our prayers. Hear us,
hear us.
Let us pray for Basil in baptism. He died with Christ. May he now share in fullness his resurrection. We pray to the Lord. God is full of mercy and compassion. May he forgive Basil of any sins he committed through human frailty. We pray to the Lord. For the sorrowing family, relatives and friends of Basil, that you may find strength and consolation in your Christian faith and in the love and support of this community. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those here today that our memory of Basil, whom we loved, inspires us with a renewed love for all of our sisters and brothers. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of us here today and for all the members of the church that we may be prepared for our hour of our own death, when God will carry us by name to pass from this world to the next. We pray to the Lord.
Lord God of justice and mercy, hear our prayers. Give our beloved dead the reward of their labors, and grant us your consolation in our loss. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Yeah.
Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Basil may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so of angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Holy Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For when, on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, whose wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and when we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs and all the saints, on his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Claude, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Basil, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly bodies after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind remittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we stand to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation,
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom of God and the glory of
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with our spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Have mercy on us, Lamb of God, you take away the sin.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into your kingdom.
For communion, to be given in the center. So the middle portions come first, and then the outer portions coming up the center, returning through the side. And our restriction for people out of town, our restriction of giving communion in the hand only still stands.
Just a few paragraphs. I've been told by my sisters that I have 2 hours, so I brought some lots of notes here. I can only speak for myself, but when I think of how he touched my life, the first word that comes to me is admiration. I'd like to share a few reasons why I admired my dad. First and foremost was his love and commitment to my mother. And I'm not just speaking about the initial commitment of my mother. I'm speaking that he committed to make her happy. If it was important to her, it definitely became important to him. Yes, Hilly. Whatever you want, Hilly. They were happily married for 49 years. And during his last days, his only concern was that she was waiting for him. And the sorbitol was on the stove. I also admire him because of the kind of father he was to us, my brothers and sisters. Yes, he loved us also very much. But he also instilled in us a core system, a core value system that defined who he was. And he was a man who kept promises and honored commitment. He was a man of integrity. Whenever we stumbled, we could have accepted our complaining and moaning, and we did a lot of that, and advised us to take the easy way out and quit. But he had none of that. He fully expected us to see things through, and all the way to the end without drama. Just do it. It has to be done, he'd always say to us. If you're here today, and I thank you all for being here, it means that he touched your life in some way or another. That means you would miss him in some way or another as well. Yes, he will be missed by his 6 remaining children, his 16 grandchildren, and his 6 plus great-grandchildren. And they will miss the humor and comfy naps in the afternoons. Friends will miss his weekend camping trips and shopping in Plattsburgh. His trips with them to Vermont, Myrtle Beach, and Florida. I will miss my father. He was the source of my work and family ethics. I will miss his inspiration. Dads are someone to look up to. Someone to follow, someone to admire, someone to be proud of, and someone to brag about. You're also someone to listen to and someone to talk to. Sometimes to impress them, sometimes to rebel against them, and some, the one most of all, with whom to share everything this wonderful life has to offer. I am so incredibly grateful and happy that I can't stand here today and tell you that I have had all this and much more with my dad, Basil. My brothers and sisters have been blessed to have had Basil as our dad, I'm sure. To say I love my dad would be an understatement, and to say I'm going to miss him would be an even greater misunderstatement. Dad was always there for everyone, family, neighbors, colleagues, friends. He was a very clever man, but never afraid of having a laugh at his own expense. He could help you with the cooking, although he was not a good chef. Or, as many of you know, he would often be Santa Claus at Christmas and have all the ladies at the party queuing up to sit on his lap. Dad was also always there for our mother, to the point that she used to joke she was like the queen, Queen Hilda. Whenever she needed anything, he was always there. And I guess he knew better. For 49 years, they shared life, everything can offer, together. They have a great team supporting each other in every way. With 7 kids growing up in a small 3-bedroom house on Roll Crescent, there were not a lot of options. They both commuted to downtown Montreal for work every day. One an accountant, the other a teacher. Then made it home to prepare dinner for all of us and sit at us and do homework. That was hardworking and compassionate towards everyone. He taught me many things, but I think most importantly, he gave us the ability to know that if you really put your mind to it, anything is possible. It is, of course, always possible to look back and remember those times when things didn't always go to plan. Traveling to the many cities and provinces, especially DEI, never went to plan. There were always storms, car problems. Yes, that valiant and wood panel country squire were a challenge. Then came on the tent trailer and the mobile trailers. Dad's love was unconditional. And this is something I will cherish from his character and take with me forever. His kindness and generosity will be remembered by all with pleasure of knowing him. I would like to thank my dad for pushing us into music. He drove us to Ranger Telemusic in Long Gale every week for lessons, even though we didn't want to go. It is by his persistence that we formed our first band with Marvin Matthews and played our first gig at Mom's school party. Then it went bigger from there. Unfortunately, my sister did not partake in this venture. They had an easy way out. Dad would do anything for us and for anyone. And he did. He was never a man of many words. He expressed his love through his actions. Today, he would certainly have shed a few tears to see how many of his family and friends have turned up here to celebrate his wonderful life. He would also be very surprised, as he was a very humble man, and we are incredibly blessed to have him as our dad, husband, granddad, and friend. There are so many stories, so many memories, so many cherished moments, which I could tell you about today. But we would need sleeping bags, light a campfire, and perhaps several days of time and still not cover everything. Oh, I see my sister's giving me the axe to cut it down. Dad, remembering you is easy. I do it every day. But missing you is a heartache that never goes away. Thank you all for being here today, and thank you.
Basil, and I'm thinking of him, and I can't say basically what I'm allowed to say about your tip of the iceberg that was already covered by Fred, which I believe didn't cover at all as well. My fond recollections of Basil go back to my early days while living in Greenfield Park in the early 70s. Of course, Basil had come to Canada a lot earlier in 1965, along with his sister-in-law Julie, who was a great support and set up house for Hilda and the rest of the family who followed soon after. Basil was one of the pioneers that made the gutsy and definitely wise move from Karachi, Pakistan to our present, the true north, strong and free. He decided to settle in Quebec, Greenfield Park, with his beloved wife Hilda, his mother, and his wonderful children, Shirley, Fred, Kenny, Nick, Carol, Michelle, and Debbie. And wow, do I have great memories of what a great job Basil and Hilda did on raising their kids to be caring, loving, and yes, always helpful. Now that Basil was in Canada, there was no slowing him down. He got a great job in Canard, later called Atlantic Steamships Containers Line. And no sooner, he started helping a lot of our people get jobs in his company as well. Proved to be a valuable resource to a lot of the newcomers. If I recall correctly, one of his first cars was a full-size station wagon to fit 7 kids and 3 adults. There were no vans at the time. Yes, he did need all that room, and yet there was always room for a few more. I believe it was at one of Shirley's birthday parties in Greenfield Park that I recall Basil in his true elements, helping in the kitchen, playing bartender, and at his best, being the gracious host, and yes, always with his beaming smile, nudging you to have yet another drink. Thinking of Basil brings back memories of our camping days in Plattsburgh. Of course, he and his family were avid campers, and the wonderful times we shared at the campground, and not to forget all the cross-border shopping trips. After our move from Quebec to Ontario in 79, we still maintained our closeness. Not as much as we would have liked to, yet close enough to meet at every opportunity. Considering all the vehicles he owned, Basil always enjoyed driving the style and bought a brand spanking new Nissan Pathfinder, not sure in which year. Was kidding as usual and said, "Who knows? This might be my last one." It is unfortunate that Celine and I didn't get a chance to meet with him more recently, considering he had moved to be with his family up west, as his early memorable years were in the east. While in Calgary, he enjoyed being in the close company of his loving kids and grandkids. Andrew, Stephen, Patrick, Kimberly, Justin, Christopher, Sarah, Daniel, Tyler, Rochelle, Danielle, Alicia, Joshua, Mark, and Emma. Sadly, Basil passed peacefully on March 28, 2020 in Calgary. He was predeceased by his wife Hilda and his son Nicholas, his mother Anna Rita, his mother-in-law Philomena, father-in-law Joseph Sebastian, his brother-in-law Roger, his brothers Porfirio, Cristino, Alarica, and sister Ophelia. Goodbyes are never easy, but I found vivid memories of Basil in his heavenly blue suit with a dark blue bow tie. Yes, his debonair look and beaming smile will remain in our hearts forever. Sure, Basil is in a happier place right now, smiling at a wonderful family and the amazing memorable legacy he leaves behind. We pray Basil be blessed with eternal happiness.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. In our last farewell, and express our affection for him. May he ease his sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Basil shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May he be welcomed to the glory of eternal life. Into your hands, Father of mercy, we commend our brother in a sure and certain hope. that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed on him in this life. They're signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace to you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Everybody has the map of the cemetery.